Did you know that with EndNote versions X8 and X9, you can share your EndNote sync library with up to 100 EndNote desktop users? It's easy to do. After setting up EndNote sync, configure your library sharing list by choosing Share from EndNote's File menu, or by pressing the associated Share Library shortcut on the EndNote Library toolbar. From the sharing window, input the email address associated with any colleague whom you'd like to grant access to your EndNote library. An EndNote X9 specific enhancement allows you to assign varying levels of access rights on a per-user basis. My colleague Rick will only need to search and cite references from my library into a shared Word document, so I'll give Rick read-only access. I also have the option of including a personalized message within the invitation email that EndNote generates. Now that I'm ready to invite Rick, I'll click the Invite button to create the associated library sharing invitation email. New library sharees will display as pending until accepting their invitation, at which time their status will update to show they're currently a member. Click the gear icon toward the right of a library sharee to remove that person from the sharing list. From this menu, you can also send a reminder email in the event your sharee missed your invitation, or change the sharee's access rights. Access rights can be modified even after a library sharing invitation has been accepted. I've received a sharing invitation, and to join this library sharing team, I'll need to click the Accept the Invitation button and input my EndNote online login credentials. Alternately, I can also create a new EndNote online account. After accepting my invitation, I can interact with this shared library by choosing Open Shared Library from EndNote's File menu. While EndNote users can configure one particular library to sync and share at any time, you can be a sharee on multiple EndNote libraries and may have more than one entry listed here. I'll access the library being shared with me by highlighting the email address associated with the library sharer and then press Open. Upon opening a shared library for the first time, all current library information must sync down to my hard drive. After this initial synchronization has taken place, once every 15 minutes, EndNote will check to see if there's any new library information to send or receive. Since this library sharer granted me read and write access, I can make changes such as adding or deleting references. I can create a custom group or perhaps attach and annotate a PDF article. As a library sharee, the only actions I cannot perform are renaming the shared library, backing up the library, or inviting others to be part of the sharing team. These are all actions that only the library sharer can perform. EndNote X8 and X9 users have access to a shared library feature called Activity Feed, which displays 500 of the most recent changes made by the sharing team. Bolded entries on the Activity Feed are selectable, and we'll show you the library content associated with that particular change. With EndNote library sharing, collaboration just got easier. Please visit EndNote.com for more information.